Okay, I post a link so you could follow along if you like. 1103, distribute candies to people. We distribute some number of candies to a row of n equals number of people, num underscore people, in the following way. We then give one candy to the first person, two candies to the second person, and so on until we give n candies to the last person. Then we go back to the start of the row, giving n plus one candies to the first person, n plus two candies to the second person, and so forth until we give two to the n candies to the last person. This process repeats with us giving one more candy each time, moving to the start of the row until we run out of candy. The last person will receive all our candy. The last person will receive all our remaining candies, which is, I guess, just the leftovers. We turn in a way that represents the final distribution of candy. Okay. I think the first thing I would kind of look at is just the constraints, because if it's a straight-up simulation problem, if the ends and the candies are small enough, then we can just simulate. If the constraints are a little weird, then then we have to kind of do some maths. And it does seem like that, even though the number of people is 1,000, so we could keep just 1,000 an array of 1,000 people. Candies, however, is 10 to the 9, which is way bigger, right? So we have to do some maths. I think one thing to kind of notice is that there is some symmetry going on. So, and maybe I have to kind of think this through a little bit, depending if n is an odd or an even number, but you can see that kind of similar to the the Gaussian something. You could have like you can imagine this 1, 2, 3 dot dot dot, and then n to the nth person, and then it kind of comes backward, right? So then it's n plus one, and then n plus two, and so forth, and then reverse dot dot dot, I guess. And at the end, there's 2n to the last person, which is the first person. So you could kind of see that, and then the second one is actually 2n minus one, right? So if you kind of do it that way, you can kind of see that for each iteration, there's 2n plus one per loop, right? Okay, and that's the first iteration. The second iteration, how much is the second iteration, right? Well, in that case, you just plus 2n to each of these, right? So, or you add 2n per person to each of those. So the sum of that is, so this would be 2n plus 1, 2n plus 2, dot, 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 and then at this end, it's 4n, right? So then in the second iteration is so something like that, because it's 4n. And then I think if you kind of run this way, let's see. So it's still 10. So let's say you do a simulation based on this fact and kind of do it that way. It's 10 to the 6th loop, maybe is fast enough. You could probably even do smarter math around that, but 10 to the 6th is like, what, a million? Yeah, so I think a million, you could probably just simulate from that, from this kind of shortcut. And given that this is easy, that's what I'm going to do for now. You guys should probably do some smarter math around like getting a formula for kind of this series, because you could kind of easily generalize that to like, 10n plus 1. So then it's just, 10 plus something like 4 times I've times n plus 1 or something like that, right? So that's what we're going to do. But you could maybe figure out a way to kind of get the summation of this formula from I to, get a closed form to kind of, and then once you get a closed form for this formula, the summation of from I to k for some k, then even if you don't, you can solve it two ways. One is kind of like find the inverse of that function to kind of get a closed form answer for that, for what k is for a given candy's input. But also, even if you don't you know, you don't want to do crazy math, or maybe the formula is crazy, or just a little bit hard. I don't know if it's crazy. Then you could do like a something like a bisection to get find a k much quicker, right? But for now, we're just going to do the linear thing, and let's just see. Okay, yeah, how long that takes? Okay, so I'm going to have a variable that just shows how much each person has. N is equal to number person, I guess, just to kind of shorten it a little bit. And then while, I is equal to 0, while 2 times N plus, I guess you could actually just, you could just, I'm just simplifying this from this to 2 plus 4 times I, 4i times n plus 1, right? Okay. Oop. One is less than or equal to candies. Candies subtract this. Maybe we should have cached it, but that's fine. It's only a couple of operations. Each person. Okay, well, been copying and pasting a lot, so maybe I should have, but I'm still a little lazy. Maybe if I have to do it one more time. Bad practice. Okay. And then, oh yeah, I put one, right? So let's, let's just print what each person get, just as a sanity check. Run the code real quick. Oop, isn't that the input? Oh, number person. Okay, I'm just bad at grammar. Or counting, maybe. But, okay, so still as it maybe should. So, I'm looking at the wrong one. Okay, I mean, there's not enough candy, so this should be 0. But let's just say you have, was it 10 to the 9? Jeepers. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay. So let's see if this once in time. Okay. So this kind of once in time, though. Maybe it's a little bit wrong. Okay, yeah, so each person has way too many. Oh, yeah, this is. Oh, I'm not subtracting enough, because so I have to times. So this is what each person has. So you have to do the number of people, and also just copy and pasting, which means I'm doing something wrong. Stylistically. Okay, so now you could see that this output is more similar to that, and you may wonder, well, shouldn't we simulate the end? Yep. We should simulate the end. So this allows us to kind of fast forward the loop. So now, let's just say results is equal to each people. And then now we just kind of loop for it forward for x in, what's the number of people? Yeah, let's just do it forward and backwards, and then we'll just kind of okay. So we solve images. If you go to the last each person, oh no, that's not right. Okay. So I guess I'd have to add another variable. That's given. Nope. Well, I guess actually I just gives me that. But now I'm. So Now I is too high. So now, okay, subtract one. Trying to think. Just trying to see if this could be negative. I guess it could be, but yeah, okay. Yeah, whatever. I'll just use another variable. That's just good. Okay. Class plus X. If plus X is equal to candy, just strictly greater than, we break. Otherwise, candy X, and then you give it to it. Okay. And then you kind of have to do it again, but in reverse. For the second loop, if last plus x plus one loop, which is number of people, candies work. Yeah, and it should be invariant that whenever this is the case, this is also the case, right? So should be okay. I think I do have one wrong thing here. I think in this case, actually, we don't, I mean, we do break, but actually, let's set candies to 0, 0 and results candies. Okay. Oh, well, in the right order would be nice there. Okay, there you go. And how is this 50 lines? I guess I have some random comments. Okay, well, that was wrong. But okay, let's get back to basic and get to trivial cases first. Should be mostly right, just maybe minor things here and there. Okay. So maybe there's an off by one, because should be 1, 2, 3, 1, but... oh, because X in this case goes from 0 to number of people and not 1 to number of people. Okay, that's fine. Except I have to do a plus 1 in like 4 lines, so maybe that's a little messy, but I guess I could just do something like this, right? Whoops. Oh, yeah, okay. Well, this one still has to be actual X. Oh my god. And also, this is wrong, because this should be number of people minus, well, I guess just negative X. Maybe minus 1. Okay, so that's right for this one, but we have to check the one where it loops back a little bit. Which I guess is the second case. Welp, that didn't go well. okay, 1, 2, 3, and then, yeah, there's probably an off by one here. Is this plus 1? Because I think, because maybe it's, because I'm negating it, but. There we go. Okay. Okay. Now let's try that ridiculous big example. Yeah, this one's in time. This should once in time anyway. Okay. Well, there's some dubious errors, but okay, which is not great. let's do something a little bit simpler. How is that 10? Let's do something trickier. I mean. Oh, starts not working with 100? How does that make sense? I mean, you wouldn't have, like, okay, well, if I have to binary search to figure out why, I guess I have to. But probably still just off by one somewhere. The last complete row. Is this off by one? No, it should be okay. Because this is a one. Yeah, okay. Welp, that sucks. But man, this was easy, but just off by ones can come up anyway. But okay. The different should get 7. So I think this is probably right. It's just this part is wrong then. Okay. Because each person gets 7. And I guess I should just. And the last one was 7. Oh, okay. Does that make sense? Oh, I guess that's just I equals 0, so I guess that makes sense. What does that mean when I is equal to 0? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so 7, 7 times 3 is 21, and then you have 29 left. Well, okay, I guess I buy that. Now you have 29, and then you should go 8, 9, 10, 8, 9, 10. What? All right. Well, let me think about this. Okay. So each person has 7. So 8, 9, 10 should be 15, 16, 17. So that part is. Wait, is it? Did I misread this at all? Man, I think I read the problem wrong again. Okay. For some reason, okay, well. This is not the first time I misread the problem, so I mean, I guess it's an easy problem. So I was doing this, for some reason I read it as snicking backwards, but I guess back to the start of it, okay. So I have all this stuff about, you know, 1, 2, 3, dot, 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 and then, man, did anyone leave a comment? Okay, well, and then I, for some reason, I read that as n plus 1, and then it goes snicking back, right, to like, to n, which I guess is true. I mean, this actually would have been a fun problem, but I solved another problem, so it's not this far. But actually, what it actually is, what is it? N plus 1 and then N plus 2 and so forth all the way to 2N, yeah, which in this case is you go to I guess I'm solving it from scratch technically, but which is just so this obviously is just sum of 1 to N, which is N times N plus 1 over 2, or maybe N minus 1 over 2, N minus 1 over 2. And then this is just, well, yeah, and then you add another n, yeah, you add n times n, so this is just, wait, this is just this plus n squared, right? Because now there's n of n's. And then that goes on. And then after that, it's 2n plus 1, so forth to 3n. So that's just all this times 2, right? Yeah, okay. So I mean, I still solve it relatively the same way. So, but now instead of all this stuff, you would have, and as you can kind of see, this is I times whatever. I mean, that's the generalization of the formula on the ith iteration. Okay, so something like that, right? So now you have did I use n? Why did I use number of people? Man, I'm confusing myself a lot today, and this is why you warm up. Possibly interview tip one is always warm up. Maybe do some, but also get enough sleep. There are a lot of stuff people should do. But so that's the sum. Each person will get I guess each person does not get the same formula in this case. I guess if you look at each straight up, you get 1, and then you get n, and then or n plus 1, and then 2n plus 1. So in this case, I think I'm a little stuck in the old way of thinking, so now it's a little weird, but that's okay. So you kind of see that what you want is I have n plus 1, and then you sum all that, right? So for nth iteration, for the kth iteration, is you the summation of that for each one is just let's see. Well, in that case, then you have k plus 1 plus the summation from 0 to k times n, so which is just k times k minus 1 over 2 times n, right? Something like that. So this will allow us to kind of get at it. Is that the summation? Oh yeah, I guess so. Okay, I mean, I could just rewrite all this since it is wrong. Oh, okay. Man, another case of the examples being a little too easy. Okay, so you have 14 rows, really? Well, I guess so, because you have... Wait, is that right? Oh, no, that's just Candy's laugh. And then 3 rows. That makes sense, right? Because then the first row, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And that's equals 6. That's, if we, our formula is right, that's just 3 plus 6. And then this is just, 3 times 3 plus 6. That's 6 times 3 plus 6, which seems like it's right. Okay. And that sums to 15, 24, and that's 49, right? 45. Okay, so I think that the math checks out here. Now for each number, okay, results, you go for x and x range n. Now it starts at 0, which is fine, maybe 1, n plus 1. Okay. So now I is the k, in this case, oh my god. Man, there must be an easier way than the dumb way that I'm doing. Maybe not, I don't know. Okay, and keep in mind that the candies left over result. I guess I could just append. And what is this for? I plus 4. Wait, is this k? Times the position, I guess. Yeah, so in this case, it's actually, okay. I times x plus 1 plus I times. Times n. Supposedly. Alright, well, let's see what that returns. Hopefully that gives me an approximately right answer. And I have to finish up the keeping in mind there's like 5 candies left over, so that's not right at all, because it's over, right? Maybe I'm off by 1 here somewhere, but I is 3. Why is this plus 1? Well, this is off by a little more than that. Should be plus x, because the plus 1 should be on the I, but that only makes it even more wrong, so. Okay. This is right, this should actually give me 12 on the first one. Okay. Now this part should be I minus 1, because, yeah, okay. Okay. I do worry what happens if this just goes over in the first time, because then I think this is just wrong, because this may go into really if I is less than 2, then you just can do weird stuff. What the fudge? Yeah, because this gives 0, negative 1, plus what? How is. All right. I think also, I think the tactical, I mean, I'm trying to do this the tricky way, which is kind of fine. But I think now that I noticed that, like stepping a little bit back, noticing even though this input is 10 to the 9th, what you notice is that this is increasing one by one. And what that means is the number of candy you use after x turn is obviously x times x minus 1 over 2 or something like that, which is x squared essentially. So roughly the number of iterations you should have done was just the square root of this. And that's probably why this is a easy and not all this fancy math. because if you count of square root iterations, that means this will run in 10 to the 5th time, which is like 10,000 or something like that, right? So it should be like 100,000. So let me just throw it the dumb way. I think you should still be able to do it my way, but maybe that's like a part two to this problem, and I'm spending like half an hour on it easy. So that was kind of sad, but yeah, that's kind of, you know. Wow. Can you just go to zero? Yeah, I think my tip here is to kind of like really should have recognized what the constraints are and what does it mean and what it. I guess I'll talk about it after I'm finished coding, because who knows, maybe I'm just wrong again. There's x results, x mod number of people. It's okay, how do I want to do it? Yeah, I'm lazy, so let's just do if candy is actually less than x, then why is this? What am I doing? Oh, there's an extra parent. Okay, I'm adding increment x, so. And there's a big case to work, and it works, okay. I mean, so one more case. This looks reasonably okay. It's hard to tell. I don't know what this diff button does anyway, but okay. Yeah, okay, cool. Yeah, so I think my tip here on this problem for myself, really, I mean, maybe most people would have a slightly better time, one, read the problem correctly. I think that's clear. If you're on an interview, make sure you really understand the problem and make sure you maybe draw it on the whiteboard and be like, oh, this is why. And hopefully, in theory, if I was working with an interviewer, that he or she would be like, hey, that's not what the question is. And then you'd be like, oh, wait, what is the question? Obviously on solo is a little bit trickier and you just go down one path and I waste a lot of time doing that. I think given that, second is also, it really matters what the constraints are. I think the way that I was going for actually, you could imagine this actually, the constraints, it'll work for bigger numbers, but that's not the problem, right? I think, you know, make sure you step back and kind of look at the problem and really know what your constraints are. For instance, when I did that, you were here for it, hopefully, maybe, you'll notice that I noticed that it was, you know, it actually wants in square root of the number of candies, and in that case, then it's fast enough, right? And to just simulate, and that's what people did. Yeah, and in terms of an interviewing question, I think, this is a way too easy question, even given that I misunderstood and kind of got to get it wrong because I was stuck in the first mind of way I was trying to solve it. But no, I mean, you can have a problem that's just, hey, do a for loop. And I don't know. And you should really be able to solve this, assuming you're not, you know, assuming that you're in, more peak shape than I am right now, I guess. But cool. I mean, in terms of, I mean, the only tricky thing here is kind of looking at the bounds and really figure out with an interview, articulate what one's in time and so forth. I think that was the only kind of insight needed. Otherwise, I mean, and once you do that, it's just a straight up simulation. Well, you could probably clean this up a little bit. There's some, but yeah. Otherwise, it should be a straightforward question. Said the guy that took 40 minutes to solve and easy.